Oh, great. This is exciting.
Yeah, the
art
is crazy.
Yeah, I can tell.
Out of here, it'll just get quiet.
Oh, really? Oh. They're just excited to go, right?
Oh, yeah. No. Everyone, when you walk around with a harness, they all want to
a certain reason why they're in certain positions, or?
Well, yeah, the lead dogs are, good dogs. Are obedient, like good pullers.
Gotcha.
They can't be squirrel chasers.
Oh, yeah.
And the swing dogs, second to front, are kind of similar, too.
Oh, okay.
They, so you want, like, all four kind of to be, because otherwise the other dog's like, the brakes on fast enough.
Makes sense.
And then, or like a new dog you might put in the wheel. Just because if you expect to untangle them a lot, they're just closer. And on our right is Dog Creek.
Oh, wow.
And then all the dogs in the middle are the team dogs. And you can have different amounts of team dogs. Because the gang line is in sections by pairs.
Okay.
And so you can add or take away sections. They're looped together.
Oh, wow.
Faster, like easy. So you go back tomorrow?
Yeah, I have work on Wednesday, so I gotta get back. Unfortunately, I wanted to stay a couple more days because I love Montana. Like this weather, we never get anything like this. So it's always
awesome.
Yeah, how many
days were you here?
I got here on Friday evening, so I got a solid 4 days.
Long weekend.
Yeah. So it wasn't bad. Yeah, it is. We try to make it a Christmas trip every year for our family.
Here or just anywhere?
For Montana, yeah.
Oh,
specifically, cool. Because we started it last year and it was just so much fun we had to come back. We tried snowmobiling last year, so we were like, we gotta do this year.
Oh, cool. So did you come to the Whitefish area or Columbia Falls?
It was Columbia Falls.
Right, last year too.
Mm-hmm.
Nice. Did you stay at Meadow Lake or Snow?
It's Meadow Lake. Yeah, I think it's amazing. I wish we could come back more than once a year, honestly, because I hear the summers here are awesome. So.
They are. There's, the rivers, the mountains, mm-hmm. like hiking and fishing or rafting.
Mm-hmm. The only thing we hear about is the bears that
boating.
You gotta be very cautious about that.
Yeah, carry bear spray.
Mm-hmm.
Good girl, Morticia. Good girl, Wednesday. Good girl, Creedence. And, good boy, Cody. Cody's real blazing. Yes, you do have to be cautious. They're really, bear attacks are really infrequent, but I think how scary they would be make them,
Yeah, exactly. Do you know anyone that's ran into a bear in Montana before, or no?
I've seen bears.
Mm-hmm.
There was a bear, Jeff called Ralph, and I think it was about 12 years ago. He visited the dog yard every night for about, a month.
Wow.
And he was so big, Jeff could put both of his feet in one of Ralph's tracks.
Oh my gosh. That's massive.
Yeah.
It's a big bear.
And, Fish and Wildlife tried to trap them. They have these culvert traps, so they go in, and there's bait in there, and then, a door drops down, and, traps them in there.
Oh, wow.
And he was so big that he ate the bait, but he must have been hanging out the back, because the trap didn't catch him.
Dang, that's crazy.
And, he had his own pile of dog bones he had collected up, but he never hurt a dog. Jeff was, totally freaked out.
I would be,
too,
that
whole month, trying to scare him off, exhausted, but, I don't know, Ralph must have been well fed.
Yeah.
Jeff actually found that Ralph was going through, there was a roadkill pile.
Uh-huh.
See? About a... Good dogs! A roadkill pile about... Easy. Look how fast he caught up to Jeff. Don't try. And I have a lighter load.
Yeah, very true.
Dump, but they the highway department had made this roadkill pile, and he was feeding off of that.
Oh man!
And then he finally went hibernation.
Jeez, yeah, that's just like a buffet for him when he
feeds
that.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah, Jeff didn't like the guy who was in charge of the I don't know what his title would be, highway.
Mm-hmm.
I guess just highway.
I mean, that's a big
there.
Thing. He should have got rid of that quicker, huh?
And the guy was a bear hunter. You can't hunt grizzlies, but there is a
Uh-huh.
Easy, and he would hunt where he piled the deer.
What?
Yeah, so that would be, you're not allowed to bait.
Yeah.
Animals, but I'd say that's
That's baiting them, yeah.
Baiting them. Yeah, that guy doesn't work there anymore. This was years ago.
Oh, okay. Well, that's good then. So how far is this trail, like, usually? Like, how far does it go?
It's 12 miles.
12 miles? Okay.
Yeah.
Wow.
And, yeah, and up here we turn onto Skunk Meadow Road, which is, we're on the McCabe Road.
Mm-hmm.
Say G, girls! Good girl, Credence! Good girl, Galaxy! And then this road is gated. There's a gate right here where the sign is.
Uh-huh.
And, but we have a permit and we're allowed to take down the gate from December through March. The state forest 5% of the rides for the permit. So Jeff was the first person to have a recreational use permit with the Montana State
Forest. Okay.
They did a lot of logging was like their main business.
Uh-huh.
And it still is their main business, but now there's like lots of recreational use permits.
Oh,
so
wow.
It's good because it's become like valuable to them.
Yeah, sure.
And they even have another position in the office near us. There's a lady that just deals with the recreational use permits.
Oh.
She has other jobs too, but it used to just all be like foresters, you know?
Mm.
I mean, she's a forester too, but it used to be, you know, the ones that were concerned with like the logging. Because they sell 3-year leases, they'll like decide, and that's kind of like how they decide sections. It depends on. Sections, like they did an only interface cut.
Mm-hmm.
They'll pick sections, kind of the interface, towns or like development, so that if there's forest fires, that maybe it'll be easier to protect. Because, like, they used to try to do it totally out of sight, I think, sometimes, and then they decide maybe we should try to, like, strategically, you know, reduce fuel around homes.
Okay.
And then they, go out and like survey it and see how much like what timber's there, and then they write that all up, and then the companies bid on it.
Oh, okay.
And the highest bidder gets a 3-year lease, so they have 3 years to log the land.
Wow.
There's rules and everything, and then after that, their time's up.
Gotcha.
Easy. Except you grow up in Atlanta too?
Yeah. I spent a lot of my summers in Louisiana because that's where my family's from, is from Georgia and Louisiana. Then my mom's side's from Louisiana, so.
Uh-huh.
Yeah, mainly in the south, so I'm used to the coldest it gets there, it's like maybe like in the 30s, you know? We've had snow maybe twice that I've lived in Georgia, and it's like,
right. It's
not a lot, but
right.
Yeah, I like Georgia a lot. It's just more of, I think I enjoy this kind of weather more than the humidity and hotness. To be completely honest.
Yeah.
Because it gets really gross during the summers. I hate the summers there.
I bet. That's what I hear.
Yeah.
There's actually a lot of people who live around here from, like, Georgia.
Oh, really? We went to a bar in Whitefish, and we found out our bartender was literally from the same county as us. Like, we were like...
Oh, really?
Yeah, it was so weird. We were like, what?
You know, there's kind of a lot of people in Georgia. I guess the ones that just, you know, escaping the heat.
Yeah.
Escaping the busyness.
Yeah, exactly.
Yeah. Yeah, she is. Yeah, I haven't had Skye yet. She's awesome. The one that he adopted.
Uh-huh.
She's doing really good. I mean, when he adopts dogs, usually they don't pick up on it quite so fast.
Oh,
some
really?
Do. She really, she's just a natural. Because there's some that are really natural to it.
Uh-huh.
But all the ones he breeds are pretty, you know, born pullers.
Oh, yeah.
But the ones he adopts, sometimes it's hard to tell. And, good dog. And some, it's just natural too, and they pick it right up.
Yeah.
And then others, they'll pick it up, but it's like a little more of a struggle, I'd say, you know?
Oh, really? Yeah.
Like, the hardest part for a lot of them is the downhills.
Oh.
The new
okay.
ones, because it's pretty fast. They gotta be coordinated.
Yeah.
Also, learning how to, like, pace themselves.
Oh.
Because sometimes
okay.
they'll just totally, like, out like towards the end, they're just like turned to jello, you know? So sometimes you have to let them go if they're like that.
Oh, really?
They'll just follow along, but then they're not going to be, you know.
Yeah, That's true. Not all dogs are very coordinated. I met some clumsy dogs.
Yeah.
So. Yeah.
It's really nice today. A little bit of snow, but not too much.
Yeah, and it's not windy or anything.
Yeah, this hill we call Andrew's Folly. Andrew didn't make the turn sharp enough, and then there's a creek that goes under.
Oh, jeez.
He ended up over the creek because, what? Try not to repeat it. Good dogs! Good girls, Guy! Good dogs! Good boy, Fester! Good dogs!
So, like, is this, like, what they used for transportation back, like, way back then? With, like, dog sleds?
Yeah,
pretty much?
Yeah, in Alaska.
Mm-hmm.
The Eskimos and Indian tribes.
Mm-hmm.